Yo, what is good guys, back again with me Matto. In this video I will show you how I make dramatic highlights on my designs. In this video I'm going to show you how to make dramatic highlights on my designs using Photoshop. There is no additional plugin in it, so if you have Photoshop, you can start right away. I usually do this method to make this design alive and aesthetic, and this time I will explain step by step what I usually do. So if you really want to follow along, let's get straight into it. Let's go! So I'm gonna start with this skull image. Actually, you're free to play with your own images. However, you can download these images link in the description below. I'll be using it to apply the highlight into it throughout this video. Basically, in this method, I'm going to painting color into it. To make this process more easier for you, I divide it into three important phases, which is the base color, the mid-light, and lastly, the highlight. I often play with three basic tools, which are the eraser tool, brush tool, and clipping mask. Okay, this time I will make lighting on the two different sides with two different colors. And to make it easier to choose a color combination, you can see the color wheel on internet to serve as a guide when starting out. Okay, first of all, usually I adjust this color tone to a bit more darker, so it can be more easier for me to decide where I want to start painting the color into the image. And in this step, I will determine the best color of the skull image that I want to make. So let's pick the gradient map, and I change the white color to dark gold color to become my basic color. And then I play a little bit with the small sled right there for just the spray between colors. And then right click into skull layer and select clipping mask. Alright, because the basic color of the skull image changed to a dark gold color, now I'm gonna add another color for the mid-light. This will create a blend soft color transition between the base color and the highlight color. Let's move and select solid color. Usually I choose a lighter color than base color for the highlight. Let's give it a name with highlight 1. Right click on the layer and select clipping mask. Then click on the layer mask thumbnail. And I'm gonna invert it by press Command I for invert the layer mask. Alright, so I go to eraser tool. Make sure your color background set black and white. Now I set my eraser brush with soft round. Play with the size value and I play with the flow value too. I suggest to set the initial value as minimum as possible, because I just want to make a slight color transition between the base color and the highlight color later. And I change the blend mode from normal to soft light. Then with the inverted layer mask active, I actually just tapping the brush, not slide my brush into it. Especially when I want to adding this color or playing in the middle area of my image. Here during the painting process, sometimes I play with the flow values to control the colors that comes out, so they aren't too strong. I also get rid of some of color left in the dark area of my images by press X on my keyboard and painting it all to the dark area. Okay, I'm done with my mid-light. Now let's adding a highlight into it. The step is still the same as before, but it just changed the color to be lighter than the mid-light color. And I also changed the blend mode from normal to hard-like to give a glow effect to the highlights. I play with a smaller brush size and a bigger flow value and start to painting from the edges and cover the area that looked bright in the image we did. And for make this output more smooth, I press X and painting it again to clean it up the edges of my highlight. Alright, now I'm gonna make this stuff more cool by adding color for the other side. I just a warmer color to make it look pop and more dramatic. So let's repeat this process once again, but for now I'm gonna speed it up this process a little bit. Let's go. Alright guys, so this is my whole process of adding highlight to my designs. As you can see, by doing 3 steps above, which is the best color, mid-light, and highlight, you can absolutely make your flat images more dramatic and aesthetic. And if you change your mind and decide to change the color or want to experiment with them for more stunning results, you can easily change the color as you like by play with the color bar until you find the best color you want. Alright guys, when I've got the perfect color composition, usually to tune up the color, I do little adjustment on the whole design using camera raw filter. I just play randomly with the slider over there. And then I adding a noise effect to increase the detail a little bit for sharpness and make the contrast more clearly into the design. Now you can see the before and after result. Yeah, I'm so happy with it. Now it's time to make this design more dope by adding another element into it and adding some of text or icon as well. But I don't know if this gonna be epic. Let's find out. Alright guys, so that it's all for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. I'll be uploading another video later this week, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. Follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes. Thanks for watching my video. See you on the next one. Peace.